And you can check out the details on how to make a clasp necklace on the HeArtfully Creating blog. You can press pause to get a better close at this if you don't want to go to the blog. But either way, here's something extra to help show
some
details.
Be sure that the beading wire will fit into the holes of the beads that you choose. Seed beads can be pretty tiny, and depending on your beading wire, you want to just check. So cut the length that you need, and about an extra 20 centimeters, so of whatever, if it's around your wrist or your neck, you decide. And you take a crimp bead and place it on the end of the wire. And the crimp bead is a special bead that's squeezable with crimping pliers. And I'm gonna make this really simple. So I am just adding a lobster claw clasp. If you wanna add a different kind of clasp, you can, but it's probably better to use this or the magnetic type. I wouldn't use it all depends. If it's perfect size for you, then you can add a toggle clasp. So you decide. Sorry, can't make up my mind. And then you insert the other end of the wire into the crimp bead because you need to make a loop. Now, you can do it a fancy way by using jump rings and things like that, but I'm making this as simple and easy as possible. And so we fidget with getting the crimp bead on, sliding it up so it's pretty snug. You can make it a little tighter if you want. You don't want it super tight. You want to be able to have the lobster claw clasp so that it can move around. I probably should have made this one a little bit tighter. Then you take your crimping pliers, which are these funky looking things, and you place the bead in. It's hard to say. You'll have to check the blog description on how to use crimping pliers for a little bit more detail. But place the crimp bead into that little indent there. And what happens is the top pushes, it's different than the bottom part of the plier. So it creates a little indent. You can't see, sorry, it's out of focus, but you squeeze it down and it will make, there's a couple photos after you can see that the top has a little bit of an indent. And the idea is that you're gonna fold that with the forward part of the pliers, the little indent at the front. And then you're gonna pinch them together. And crimping pliers, the whole purpose is so that you can secure wires or beads on a wire or whatever. And sorry, again, it goes blurry, but I'm squeezing towards the front end. I would practice with some crimping beads to get it. Sometimes I will, after I do it, because I just don't trust that it's secure enough, I will bring it to the back of my crimp pliers and give it an extra squeeze. I notice some cheap crimp beads will shatter. So that might happen. I added on this extra crimp bead just to show again how to do it, because it's a key thing in jewelry making. If you want to do things with clasps, if you do things with knots like we did in the doing a long necklace demonstration, then you don't have to worry about crimp beads. But it's something that I used quite a lot when I was making a lot of jewelry. And again, you make the indent, squeeze it, and now you move it to the forward little indent in your plier, because you notice there's different indents, and then you kind of angle it and you're squeezing it so it's folding over into the little indent. So hopefully that makes sense. Like I said, check out the blog for details on the section on crimp beads. That'll be where I post this video. Just look below or above, depending where I place it. So here's some close-up photos of placing it on the wire and then squeezing it. See the little indent right there? And then just ignore the extra crimp bead. So there's what one side looks like. It's smooth, and then the underside is indented. And then when you place once you make that indent, then you put the crimp pliers and fold it. So you place it into the end little loopy thingy. That's a really technical word, but that's what we're using. And now you would like to start stringing on your beads. First, I do like to give a little tug to make sure my crimp bead is securing the wire. So just give a little bit of a pull.
And now I like to use little collect little dishes. This is actually from a drumstick ice cream cone. The lid was perfect to hold beads. So I'm going to just string up new scents or reason, just random beads. Totally, if you want, you can be random, you can put whatever you want. I used ones at the beginning with a little bit bigger hole. These are larger seed beads, and I'm gonna slip the end of the wire to tuck it away. I don't wanna cut it super short, so I'm gonna tuck it into the larger beads. If the double wire doesn't fit, then switch your beads out. I had to do that, because I found out the hard way. So then I'm just going to keep on stringing, and this is something you don't need a beading needle because the beading wire is stiff enough. And this beading wire, I'm not an expert on that. I just kind of pick a standard beading wire. It comes in different thicknesses. Again, check the blog. There is a description on beading wire and about different thicknesses and kind of what it consists of. It's a pretty neat thing, and it comes in so many sizes and strengths, actually. So I'm just going to keep picking up beads, and I'm not going to bore you with showing you every single bead that I pick up, but I'm using an assortment just for fun because we've shown different bead types on the blog. So I'm using, as you can see, a round one, a cube one, a faceted coin-shaped bead, a bead spacer that has rhinestones laying there on the table, and this is a round bead that has a really cool finish. Just having some fun. And then we just keep on stringing. The sparkly green one is called a shambhala bead. I am not sure why, but that's what apparently it's called. That's a bead spacer, the one I was talking about, that has some rhinestones. And you can put that between whatever beads you want. Usually round ones, you want the ones that fit. You can get square bead spacers, but yeah, it's just fun. So obviously this actual piece that I'm making isn't anything that I would wear because I'm just throwing a whole bunch of beads on just to show you how to do it. So I personally wouldn't choose this because it's very random, but I have done necklaces actually that have an assortment of beads. Actually, if you want to, you could totally, if you have straight beads lying around, they don't have to be all a certain color or a certain style or shape. You could totally make basically a collage of beads. That's something called a freshwater pearl. It actually is a genuine pearl. We talk about pearls in the blog under bead types, and I never mentioned freshwater pearls, but freshwater pearls are not perfectly shaped. They're very natural, and I think they cultivate them in oysters with special something or other to make them grow really fast, and then they're dyed. They don't actually come lime green, and that's a lamp work bead. We talk about that. And so I sped it up, so like I said, don't want to bore you. And we're going to add some more seed beads and get ready to end this. Okay, now it's time to finish it off. Once you've strung on all the beads you want, you need another crimp bead. So I am chasing it around with my wire, trying to find that teeny weeny hole. And I'm looping it onto a jump ring. You can use a solid jump ring in this case, or a split one where you could pull it apart with pliers. Again, check the blog on how to open jump rings. In this case, you don't need to, unless it's all, unless you made the loop and forgot the jump ring. So that's to hold the clasp. And I'm going to thread it through. I put larger seed beads at the end. You don't have to use seed beads, you can use larger beads, as long as your wire fits like that to hide the extra tail. And then I'm going to squeeze it. So again, check the, I don't want to bore you with repeating it, so do the whole squeezing. And now I'm ready to open up my lobster clasp with a little lever and stick it on there. And check out the details below for how to use clasps and
especially the lobster claw and jump rings. And I hope you enjoyed that. Thanks for joining me today. I hope that was useful. Make sure you have fun when you're creating and experiment and play around with colors and shapes. So I'd love to hear from you. Leave your questions or comments below if you're on the YouTube channel. Thank you.